For many young people, turning 16 marks the start of adulthood. Suddenly, you are legally entitled to work, get married, and take control of your finances.
But are young people ready for this responsibility when they leave school? Research shows many youngsters rack up thousands of pounds of debt in the first few years after leaving school.
Nicole Goodwin has been investigating what schools do to prepare their pupils for life outside education.
When you're dashing between lessons and working towards exams, life beyond the school corridors can seem a long way away. But the moment you have to stand on your own two feet comes around very quickly. For Samantha Monaghan, that moment hit suddenly when she fell pregnant months after completing her GCSEs. She had to support herself and her son, Austin.
When I left school and then got pregnant, I had no idea about money or the world. Like, I didn't have a bank account at that point, but nobody told me how do I go about applying for a bank account. The school should maybe prepare a bit more for adult life. I left school at 15 and I was just in the big world without knowing any information about how to survive in it.
The Department for Education told me financial literacy is compulsory in schools as part of citizenship lessons for 11 to 16 year olds. Pupils are taught about the importance of personal budgeting, money management, and the need to understand financial risk. At Joseph Swan Academy in Gateshead, head teacher Heather Scott admitted it is a challenge for schools to find time to fit this in.
I think schools would struggle because we have to deliver so much now. Our curriculum is so full of what we need, with a lot of just looking at the academic side, all the new specifications that we have to deliver. But actually, there's always a place for this because I do think it's so important.
How you get loans, how you save, what type of bank accounts you can get. And it's just simple things like credit cards, like how much interest a credit card has. Like, I didn't know that there was a difference. I just thought all credit cards were bad and found out that credit cards sometimes aren't necessarily the devil and they can kind of be used as well.
Well, recently we just done this thing called the Key Project. And it's basically where we design some product and sell it for as much money as we can. And it basically teaches us about money and stuff.
In all of the year groups, there's a focus on money. So it might be what a mortgage is, what a loan is. But do you actually know until you leave school and go out and live by yourself? I'm not too sure, but I think we prepare them as best we can.
And yet it seems many young people find it difficult to manage their money.
Research shows that one third of young people have debts of up to £3,000, excluding their student loan.
Youth organisations are now stepping in to help those who've already left school.
We see young people who, perhaps when they get their first apprenticeship and they're suddenly earning, you know, £100 a week that they've never had before, and the choices that they then make in terms of what they spend that money on aren't always the best ones. Although that should be a really positive step, we can see that that can sometimes be a flashpoint as well.
Any Youth in Newcastle is training these young people to deliver the Money for Life programme to others.
I learned how I use my bank account and how I divide my money, and it's very useful for me to learn.
Did you receive any of this sort of education in school?
No, none at all.
It was like an hour class on money management, and it was literally just like how to read a bank statement and how to kind of how to budget, but not in as much detail.
Despite feeling unprepared for life after school, at 21, Samantha became a homeowner and returned to education to study biomedical sciences at Northumbria University.
4 years ago, looking at myself now, I would never have thought I would have worked full-time since he was one, then buying a house and going to university, studying while working full-time and funding that myself, and him still being such a happy little boy. I want to do something with my life and I'm excited, and people always say to us, you should be really proud, and I am.
Hopefully things have improved since Samantha left school, and schools now realise the importance of financial education, because one thing is certain: everyone does have to deal with money throughout their lives. Nicole Goodwin, ITV News.